coach has left that in charge of Daniel Lewis. Stephen Maher comes out. So this is a strong-looking Canada lineup that we're seeing here. And there's young Sharon Vernon, who is going to be a superstar in this business. Daniel Jansen van Doorn, one of the Olympians, comes in. Lucas van Berkel, another very experienced middle blocker. And their setter is young Byron Ketourakis, who's impressed, as has Daniel Lewis on the sidelines. Real powerful motivator. This is the team he sends out. They're not here with a specialist libero, so somebody is pressed into service. Stephen Marshall, though much an offensive weapon, will be wearing the libero's jersey today. So it's a start then for the veteran, Kurihiro Shimizu, who's been very much on the fringes of this squad. His professionalism and his infectious energy is a huge asset. It's a start also for Naonobu Fuji, who's come off the bench as setter many times. Akira Yamauchi, Masahiro Yanagida, the captain, Haku Lee, we've seen him come off the bench many, many times. And Tsubasa Isahara with Taichiro Koga getting the start of libero. Yuichi Nakagaichi has rewarded his squad. Most of these guys we've seen in action, but from the bench. This is a first start of this World Cup for most of them, and it's a special moment for most of them. So will a much-changed Japan lineup have their hands full with a full-strength Canada squad? The last match of the 2019 World Cup. Japan versus Canada over five sets, about to get underway. It'll be Japan serving with their captain Masahiro Yanagida there serving right across the board. Hugely improved. The next thing that they want to really work on is their blocking game. Traditionally a weakness for Japan. Yanagida takes a bit of net cord on the first serve. And comes back pretty effortlessly there from Lucas van Berkel. Giant powerhouse right in the middle of that court there for Canada. Make no mistake, Canada are more than capable of holding their own here with Japan if they are at their best. Ketourakis, who's quite a server, sends that one in, and that's pushed away by Kurihiro Shimizu. Japan on the board. All about the right decision making and executing. Shimizu managed to achieve both, which will bring in Akihiro Yamauchi. Deceptively sneaky server. Had Brazil running around a little bit yesterday. Ho grips that one down the line, but out. Oh, there may be an early challenge here. Ho was looking rather surprised there. It is going to be challenged. Going to check the in out. It was pretty close. Ho certainly looked round as if he was expecting the bench to say, oh yeah, that didn't look right at all. Good coach will always back his players. That is a good call. It was a great spot by Hogue as well. That's Isahara. No winner for him. Here's a winner. Stephen Maher ripping that one cross court. Very positive start this by Canada. Well, Japan obviously want to sign off the World Cup that they've hosted in such style with a victory. They've picked the wrong team if they expect it's going to be a rollover job from the opposition. Canada don't roll over. Nice bit of containing work on the block, but they make the breakthrough there. Haku Lee. And we send Shimizu back to the service line. good serve. Poe picked up nicely, dispatched beautifully by Van Berkel. Nice job by Hove there. Nasty serve to deal with, but he got it. Put it up there for his setter, who did have to adjust. Van Berkel with the put away. A bit of an audition this for young Byron Ketorakis, the setter. With Brett Walsh no longer here. Sent long. Did it take a touch? No, it did not. So he's a harder with a miscue. He wants to challenge that. That's something else. I say, don't challenge it or out, because that was definitely out. So the challenge is block touch. Did it touch a Canadian fingertip on the way through? That's what Yuichi Nakagaichi would like to know. That's what 8,000 people in this arena would like to know. Well, doesn't look like that, does it? No. Sure, Vernon was there. Nothing on it at all. Job containing Canada here. Go with Shimizu again. That one's going to be picked up by Hogue. Well, that's Sharon Werner. Didn't take a touch either. So that's a missed fire from young Vernon. He's had a good World Cup. Very, very productive. I think they're going to be building their national team around Sharon Vernon. In the future. Sonara with Sale. Vernon tries to sneak one over there. Here comes Shimizu. No, he can't power a winner through there. The block is doing a nice job of containing, and then Vernon does swing and connect straight at Taichiro Koga. Early observations, and I'm sure they're looking at this on the Japan sideline as well. The outside hitters for Japan are really struggling with the Canadian block. Nishida and Ishikawa bring such power and energy. But their replacements at the moment really struggle to find consistent winners. Defensively, Japan really sound. Just get the net serve on the side out. Well taken. A dunk from Maher. He's missed it. That's a surprise. So, yeah, you put your hand up. When it's on you, it's on you. And everybody makes mistakes. It's the right idea, and it looked like an easy put away as well, but he's just sent it the wrong side of the line there, Stephen Maher. These things happen. So Lee stays on serve. Sent in a much flatter one. It fizzed in there. Stephen Maher doesn't make second mistake. Now back to serve. Picked up off the floor. No winner there for Yamauchi. Oh, and a real big one. To the first technical timeout with a useful lead, 8-5. It's a very positive start by the North Americans.
On 15, he's taking abnormal risk on that float, okay? I think we gotta go like this. Okay, I don't want to give him any freebies. I think he's gonna hit the net or it'll be way out. You can, on transition, middle. We can go pure read, especially on 15. Okay, but don't just leave, because you got show here, especially in Byron.
Keep going. 1-2.
Mar after a timeout serves. Just misses. Oh, he got that one. That wasn't far away. That was a really good serve. So now Nobu Fujii will drop back now, the little setter. Getting a start over. Sakita today is Yuichi. Shuffles the deck pretty comprehensively. Well, if you think about a reshuffle here, if this carries on like this. As Japan continue to look to try and find the 2 points they need here to level it up. Mara's picked that one up beautifully. Misses. No. Not touch. Certainly didn't get it in, but there is a touch. It's the ball from the chair. No argument for Japan, so obviously it did touch somebody on the way through. So Hogue will drop back then at 11-8. Look at the this lead. Kunihiro Shimizu then. Up next. Oh, it's a nice one. Hogue's done brilliantly. Can't find a winner down the line. Now, what can Japan do with this? Tough take, this. Not far, but he's done beautifully there. Tsubasa Isahara had an awful lot of work to do here. The block's set, but they can't get it back. Mark that one up as a big win for Isahara. There's a point back. Got to keep Shimizu back there. The last one was good. This one's set about 5 meters too deep. Side out.
Come on, boys. Hey, setters up.
Sent in by Van Berkel. Isahara looked for another winner. Didn't get it.
Lovely
stuff. Really important dig there from Byron Kitarakis earlier. All Canada allowed them to transition out here, and Mark making mid speed of the three-man block. Just dropping it inside the baseline. Nobody could get it, not even Taichiro Koga. Didn't expect to see the Libero's flying around all over the court, but they can't get everything. Japan are back to chasing a couple of points here. Solidly digging in at the moment, Canada. Easy take. Be in a comfort zone here, Canada. Throughout most of their matches in this World Cup, even the ones they've lost, Canada have had their opponents dancing around and scrambling. At the moment, Canada He did not have this where they want it. Shimizu runs it off the right side out. Quite happily side out though, Canada. And with the front running team. We'll play this game all night long. Haku Lee then. Another one of these tricky servers. Not the big power server, but somebody can just make the ball float around there. Mars watched it carefully. Yeah, pretty tight on the right hand side there for Jas Van Dorn. Yeah, the Japan serve overall. Shimizu's sent in a couple of fairly heavy ones, but at the moment Canada are finding it pretty easy to deal with. That's causing a lot of problems here for Japan. With their big servers on the bench. Fuji with serve out, too easy again. Meanwhile, gets a right kiss, can take that on second touch. With the service receivers under no pressure at all. Canada just very comfortable at the moment. They're not got the set one, but they're not being pushed or stretched at all.
Good guess, no problem. Just remember when you manage, 8 or 17 can be short, he's the worst. Okay, but listen, we're starting out well. I don't want everybody just to be popping it in.
I mean, this
smart is your smart tactical serve. Look, on 17, okay, we need to be tight and small. 4-1 are ready to collapse. He's an internal. On one back row, if we have two, we steal the line. Force on the medium.
Hey, 17 is a hit. So on high ball, fucking go. I have to press it.
Yeah, yeah.
1-2.
So after technical timeout, Canada will look to try and pad their lead a little bit more with the Rio Olympian Daniel Jansen Van Dorn back there. So 16-13. There have been no substitutions, not even specialist servers coming in. Nothing. Canada wouldn't change anything. They're comfortable at the moment. Rocked off the block by Kunihiro Shimizu, side out. Important for Japan not to let this gap grow any wider if they want to come back and take this first set. This is where they're going to have to make their move. After that second technical timeout, that's when the intensity just goes up a notch. And Canada comfortable, and we haven't even seen much of Sharon Vernon. They've not needed him. It's been Ma and Hoag running the show. Off the back of really good service reception. He's another one that whistles away there. Yanagida sends it long. Katarakis, one of those players that you fancy for an ace. Yeah, there you go, right on cue. I had a feeling that was coming. Oh, it's going to be tough for Japan to pull this back. It's a lot of topspin, a bit of swerve. Katarakis can add another ace to the collection. And Yuichi Nakagaichi and Philippe Blaine, the French assistant coach, who does such a great job of adjusting in-game. We have a lot to talk about here.
And guys, first of all, you have to change about serve. It's not a big serve. What's that you do? So continue to push with this. Okay? Thank you.
are the 17th face of this World Cup. From Byron Ketsourakis. Puts Japan in an even worse position than they were. They're now chasing 3 points, and that's if they side out here. Well, it does get picked up just about, and then a big miss. Oh, that's a big miss. Yamauchi sent that too far. Well, you can forget the first set now. Japan have lost this. They won't be coming back from this. Too many errors. Just not enough pressure from them in this first set. It's been really comfortable for Canada. Giannakis can mix up his serving. Coe can't find it. There's a push back there. Shimizu over there. Well, they were chasing 2 points. Now they're chasing four. And on the evidence that we've seen so far, they don't have the servers. You're back to go on a run of points here. Oak picks up a comfortable one. Vernon rips that down the line. Side out. Easy take. Another simple put away. All they've got to do is execute here, Canada. They really don't have to do anything fancy. Just fairly basic volleyball is getting the job done here. Hogue. It's a little bit more air underneath that one. Shimizu gets blocked. They continue to contain really well. They contain that. Julie finds a little gap. Takes it nice and early. We're going to see the first switch up. It's an interesting one as well. It's Yuji Nishida, the 19-year-old teenage terror, comes in. But only as a blocker here, with Fuji checking out. They're trying to pick up a block point. Hope takes the serve. There is a little block there. There's contact to the net. And that's a good Japan. Lamar got lured in there. Only a drag near the net. There's always the danger of a stray hand contacting the nylon. So they pick up 1 point. Shimizu puts that one. Really dangerous. Very, very good bit of setting there from Ketsourakis. That was not a good take from Hogue, who dragged it off the floor. Ketsourakis really had to react quickly here. One-handed, hung it up there. Couldn't have done any better. Vernon on rushing. Doesn't even find a block to beat. Just send that away. So a switch up. Sakita, the setter, coming in. Oh, yeah. Coaching staff are starting to shuffle things around a little bit now, aren't they? Van Berkel with serve. That's not a good take at all. Nishida. Yeah. His first swing produces a point. Looking for Daniel Lewis, the Canada coach. You're looking at Nishida. You're thinking, I'd rather you were back in the bullpen. I don't want you coming out here. But they need some energy. They need some hitting. Isahara with serve. It's again a nice, comfortable take. Simple put away for Vernon. Well, Canada will just keep hoping that these serves keep coming in as soft and safe and as easy as this, because they will expect to execute a very high percentage of winners, as they have in this first set. Time running out for Japan. Got to side out here. Nagita just about gets there. Nishida just brings a whole different pace to the game, doesn't he? Hits hard, hits with authority, hits with confidence, and takes some dealing. And guess what? The other big hitter's in as well. Yuki Ishikawa comes in. Well, they're not holding back here. Yuichi Nakagaichi has given his starters a chance. It's not been working. So they're putting on the power show now. The two big hitters for Japan, both working in tandem. It's Lee with serve. Sends that way too long. It's probably come too late in the day to rescue this first set. Canada will certainly know that they're going to have to up their game a bit now with those two changes. Ma sends that one into Ishikawa. And there you go, Nishida. And all those outside blocks that were containing and containing and containing. Suddenly they're struggling a little bit now. Sagidu will come out as Shimizu comes in. That is just very specific. They're trying to get a block point here. Big serve, Nishida. They've been in a comfort zone on service reception for Canada. If this goes over the net, they're about to get knocked out of their comfort zone. Nishida brings it. Let's see what he's got. Yeah, there you go. Different game now, isn't it? Pope rips one back. They got a block on it. Here goes Ishikawa. They're scrambling around, but they've got it back under control with Hogue. The block's there. Containing again. Backside they go. Vernon, who misses. A little bit of pressure coming. Suddenly, Canada are now having to fight a little bit. One of those points comes back. Canada have to react. Daniel Lewis, quite rightly, takes a timeout. Different personnel for Japan and a whole new ball game.
Good work, guys. That's a great reception, okay? We're 1, 2, 3. Dan has help on short and Myra's got the tape.
Side out there at set point. If Japan take another one, they're breathing now. Canada's next. Big moment in this first set. Nishida sends another one in. Mars all over the place with that one. Tough take this.
Yeah.
Now they can pick it up with Ishikawa. Well, Hogue's got under it, but they really are playing full on defense here. Hogue goes for a massive swing, gets a touch, takes it to set point. That's a very important swing. Should get Canada over the line here. Fujii will come into set. Nishida will sit back down again. I suspect we'll see him at the start of the second set, though. He may even come back if they side out here. Canada send that one 2-1. Just floated in the air there for Daniel Jansen van Doorn. He tried to just drop it on the line. No, Nishida does not come back in, but Ishikawa's got a serve on him as well. 2 points needed to extend this beyond 25 points for Japan. Here's the first one, and it's 2-1. First blood Canada. They were comfortable for most of that first set until the changes came. And Japan had left it too late to mount a comeback. The atmosphere has gone rather flat in the Green Arena. This wasn't supposed to happen. Japan are going to win their last match at this year's World Cup. They're going to have to do it coming from behind. Let's take a look at the numbers then. Well, there was no blocking to speak of at all, just the one block point, the one ace serve. That came for Canada off the serve from Byron Ketourakis. Just look at all those attack hits. Canada barely had to get out of second gear for most of those winners. Japan barely struggling into double digits. But let's see what they do second set, Japan. Do we see more of Nishida and Ishikawa? Maybe even Tatsuya Fukuzawa getting involved. That first set was certainly far too easy. Hope, Mar and Vernon there pretty much had their way. Not perfect service reception, point after point after point. Start this second set. A very dangerous server now back to the service line. Their setter, Byron Ketourakis. Japan won't want to be chasing this second set, having spent pretty much all of the first set on the chase. Canada will be very happy to see no Ishikawa, no Nishida. Hiro Shimizu will get Japan off to a good start. Let's come back to the starters. Giving the starting crew a chance to write a different narrative here in this second set. Akihiro Yamauchi. Next, not a good take from Mar. They get away with it. Ho just has to push. And Japan should be able to transition here and do. Coming in from the back, Masahiro Yanagida. She will stay on serve. Yeah, pretty comfortable take. Oh, just a misfire. Lucas van Berkel just didn't lose it. Lost it in flight there. Oh, that was down to the setter or down to the swinger. Only those two know. But Ketourakis certainly couldn't find van Berkel. And Japan find another point. Yamauchi is very, very tame serves. Really having trouble adjusting to these. Oh, hasn't done a brilliant job with that. Vernon needs to put this away and does. Side out. So here's Nick Hogue, 3. Really nice take from Yamauchi. Absolutely no play available there at all. And again, he gets blocked out of it. Tsubasa Hisahara having a bit of a tough time. Blocked twice. Got the first one back. Sharon Bernard made sure the second one didn't come back. Just like that. Canada level up. It will do if they can hold a point on serve, should I say. Ahead of myself there. Hogue will be looking to bring in another big one. No, he takes it everything off it. Yankee does read it well, and that's just missed. Japan will celebrate the point. And once again, with Shimizu and Hisahara as the outside hitters, Japan's block is getting a lot of touches. There's a lot coming back. Shimizu with serve. Nice take from Marshall. And Meyer doesn't get a touch. A little perplexed there because that was all set up. It went that long, you thought, well, it must have taken a touch, but nope, it didn't. So that'll keep Kunihiro Shimizu back there. Scrambling as well. Vernon, brilliant bit of rescue work, and then he does get his winner there, Hisahara. Mark that one down as a win for Taichiro Koga, the little Libro who scrambled under that. Yeah, he's celebrating. That's it. Lovely dig there. And Hisahara needed this. So his morale's back up sky high. Canada starts to switch things up with Derek F. coming in at setter for Keturakis. Shimizu's serve, it's a much better take this time, and Ma absolutely rips that through. Drops it just inside the baseline as well. Absolutely super kill that one. Hisahara coming in to serve to try and take Japan to the first technical timeout. Ma picks that one up. Vernon rips it away down the line. Again, it's another serve that just doesn't challenge at all. Gets exactly what it deserves. Vernon bringing the heat there. Let's see if Vernon can bring the heat from the service line. It's too much heat. It's Japan, 8-4 in the first technical timeout.
We have to continue to try, because then we continue to play like this. Hey, to help him, close completely line. Because anyway, he's sure that he cannot close, he should not be covered. So close completely line, he will be closer on the ball. And yeah, just same thing with number 7. We have to defend these two. Because they are just playing high to speed now. So you have to fight with this. You have no other solution. So you also go back. Close to the antenna. And he doesn't be close to the ball.
much more positive energy coming from Japan in this second set. Even this early in the first set, things didn't look right at all. Much improved here as Haku Lee serves 8-4. Serves Hogue, who has an easy take, and Ma has an easy cross court. Well, it's Canada doing the chasing here early in this second set. That's as easy as 1-2-3 again. Decent squad that Canada have sent over here. Most of them were bronze medalists at the World League back in 2017. They're not mugs. Nagida denied. Hogue has a swing through that. The containing block is there. Now Canada can have a proper setup and they take it with their Daniel Jackson man. That's a point coming back. Really good defense and they transition out of there beautifully as well. Epp puts it up there. Jackson Van Dorn knocks it down. So here's Ma. Better take. Lovely finish from Alameda. Very, very popular player with the Japanese crowd. Their captain, Masahiro Yanagida. There go the chants right on cue. Yanagida serving, it's now Nobu Fuji at 9-6. Yeah, an easy take, Marshall picked that one up. Send that down, but he'll catch the antenna on the way down. Touch that antenna, that's a dead ball. So he just got that one wrong. Yeah, that's one of those, isn't it? Now, should have just adjusted my line there. Tune the bomb sights, hasn't he? Fuji. Oh, comfortably collects that. Jackson Van Dorn comfortably dispatches it. Yeah, with the forward set. That's as easy as you like. With a double barrel surname, Jansen Van Dorn goes back to serve now. Watched all the way by Koga. Yeah! And dispatched somehow by Yanagida. Not allowed to take two touches in a row, so although he got the dig, as soon as he kicked it up in the air, Jansen Van Dorn, that's a dead ball as well, right there. Sometimes the instincts just kick in. You cannot have two consecutive touches. Japan. Staying in good shape. Better shape as Yanagida fizzes down an ace. This is a bit more like it. Much more energy. Look at the squirm on that. That looked like it was coming down the line and then it just took off, didn't it? That took a swerve off there. Daniel Lewis quite right to call the timeout there. Timeout. They'll have to deal with another Yanagida serve. Served well as a pinch hitter throughout this World Cup. There's another beauty. Mars made a mess of that. Hogue will get it, but it'll be Hoist and Hope time, and Epp was slow reacting there. Terribly emphatically. You'd expect to win points like that 19 times out of 20, but you've got to execute. Japan did. Well, it's time to switch things up. Canada. Kent will come back out. Kitarakis is back in there, but the second set is getting away from Canada in a hurry. Going to be the next side out, but they're chasing 5 points here, Canada. Kitarakis with the serve. Nobody needs to tell Takahiro Yamauchi that he should have had that one. Not only did he not get it, he missed it badly. Shrug that off, forget about it. But that's one of those points back for Canada, which means Kitarakis is still there, and he's a handful on serve. Shimizu can't get away. What's happened there? Straight Canadian contacting the net. Yeah, that's a head scratcher for the coach, isn't it? Done all the hard work. You got the cross-court defenders in place. It doesn't matter. Oh, side out. Yamauchi. Marshall takes that. Tough take that for Kitarakis. He's arguing that there is no foul there, and that is going to be challenged. Out of the second referee, having a word with Daniel Lewis, they're very genial, very good referee. We'll make sure everything stays calm. Lewis is fiery, he's a real competitor. Let's see what we get out of this. Net touch. That was the call that went against Canada. Saw Kitarakis' reaction. He thought, no, I didn't touch the net. He's got a point. He's got a point. He's absolutely right. But the original call will stand. Again, taken by Ma. Can't get that one away from the block. Lee can't find the winner either. They all scramble around and then they all end up leaving it. Lee and Yamauchi, the two middles, were both closest and they both stopped and left it for each other. Look at this. There they go. No, yours, yours, no. Ah. Gonna make these decisions in nanoseconds. Canada get away with that one. They could do some big serving from Nick Hogue right here. That's a good one. Nagui's got under it. Well, there's some work to be done here, and Shimizu has to take that and takes a touch off the block. Beautiful execution from Kunihiro Shimizu. That'll take Japan into the second technical timeout pretty comfortably here. Technical timeout. interesting switch-up as Nishida is going to come back initially as a blocker. Looks like Fuji, the setter, is going to come out here as they look for a block point. But Canada don't want to see Yuji Nishida, that's for sure. But he's coming in, at least for 1 point. Confirmation then. Nobu Fuji, who will check out. Nishida's in there to try and get a block as Shimizu comes in. Canada seek side out here. Just to keep the damage down to 5 points. It's getting pretty much mission impossible. This Hogue takes that nicely. Ma picks that up. And yeah, just couldn't get his feet under him, could he there? Really unfortunate there for Shimizu. Goga had got under it. Shimizu will come out, and Sakito will come in to set. So, the Japanese coaching staff continuing to shuffle the deck here late in a set. We saw a lot of this in the first set. And they are doing it again, and Canada now need to assault this 5-point deficit. Sakito will send that backside, and there's a block. Comes in. Jansen Van Dorn with the wipeout of Tsubasa Hisahara. Just look at that. They were both there, Mark and Daniel Jansen Van Dorn, and there was no way through for Hisahara. Well, there's 1 point back, pretty easily as well. So Van Berkel will stay on serve. Better take from Yanagida. Pipe attack. Got blocked back as well. And suddenly, Jansen Van Dorn is absolutely everywhere all over this net. Back-to-back stuffs. That's produced a timeout for Japan, who see their lead shrinking here, courtesy of that man right there, Daniel Jansen Van Dorn.
One more, you will serve on you. Good reception and fight behind. Okay.
Japan have had their warning. And they've seen their lead trimmed on back-to-back stuffed blocks. That is the key to go here. Back attack again. That's nicely taken. Absolutely drilled in there. Hogue just couldn't get control. They've been very welcome. Side out for Japan. They were no longer coasting through this second set. They've got to win it now. He's an ace out of nowhere for Hisahara. That helps. That helps a lot. Stephen Marshall just seemed to lose this in flight, didn't he? Was he unsighted? No, he had that clearly. Just misjudged it. Now, that's the problem when you're chasing a big deficit. You cannot make any errors at all. So Canada in deep trouble again. Hisahara, Marshall doing a lot better this time. Werner finds the cross-court kill. Side out. Werner mixes his serves up really nicely there. And then the shooter rips one off the block. Send Lee back. Japan looking healthy here.
once again. Ooh, Hodes made a mess of that. Can they get a swing out of this? Oh, has to find something and does brilliantly, absolutely brilliantly.
Big, big gap there. Just keeps them just about intact here in this second set. Well, more than just about. They've got a lot of work to do to claw this back here. Nah, with serve, Sakita scrambles over there and blocks in place. And Japan pick it up, they won't block it the second time. Yamauchi gets his reward at the second attempt. Important pickup, really important pickup from Isahara earlier in that rally. And that block looked like it was going to come back. Shimizu will come back in for Sakita. So they sacrifice the setter for a blocker. Watched perfectly there by Marshall. That's all about Stephen Marshall. Couldn't handle that any better at all. Mark with the put away. So that's the dangerousness she has served dealt with. He will now check out as the setter does come back in. And it's Fuji again. What a rotation of personnel for Japan. Canada still chasing, needing 4 points. Daniel Jansen banned all his back-to-back stuffs. Gave him a glimmer of hope. He looked to do something from the service line. That could be trouble. Done well there. Really important there from Fuji. Can they get a brilliant cover from Kogo? Is there a push available there? No, he's into the net. Everyone thinks that was a wonderful, wonderful play from Yanagida, and it was. He got an outrageous angle, but he had to slam the brakes on just quickly. His momentum took him through the net. So, Canada pressing again. Big serves, it's a beauty. Mars had all sorts of trouble with it. Can Ho get a swing on this? He can't really. He sent far side on that block. Van Berkel this time takes out Ishikawa. With Ketorakis right alongside him, who got the decisive touch. It's the setter. Ketorakis. We know Ketorakis can block, and we also know he can serve. If he gets an ace here, Japan will be sweating. There is a collective sigh of relief around this arena. As that one skidded off the net court and just dropped the wrong side of the line for Japan. That was a let-off. Hiro Amauchi then. But it took a touch. Hogue sizzles that one. This is going to be a problem, isn't it? Tough take there from Ishikawa. Easy pickup for Marshall. Easy put away. Suddenly they are bouncing it. Canada, Lucas Van Berkel, as they sense they might have a way back into this set after all. Canada Fender looked out of touch. Almost in a position to get Japan really sweating. This has got to be side out for Japan. They can't allow this to get any closer. Ho goes for a big one again. Yanagida picks that up. Yamauchi picks that up. Shimizu wraps one off the block. They had a block there. Shimizu just too good for it. Hard work this for Japan, though. It's the 11th game out of 15 days for all these teams. It does take its toll. Tough to stay sharp, sharp and fresh. It's a beauty there from Shimizu. Hoke's done really well. Ma just has to push it. Shimizu picks that up. And it'll go to Ishikawa, who will send that on its back. And that should be it. Set point, Japan. A specialist libero might just have got under that. Not sure what they'd have been able to do with it from there, but Stephen Marshall gave it everything he had, just couldn't quite get there. So it is set point, but it's also timeout, Canada. Into the second set, Shimizu. What a beauty. Marshall couldn't get it. It's an ace. That's a beauty. They love it here in the Green Arena in Hiroshima. Japan have bounced back beautifully. Chasing early in the first set. They set the tone right at the start of the second set. Canada couldn't play catch-up any more than Japan could play catch-up in the first set. That's why we're level. One set apiece. outside, the numbers much improved on the attack hit perspective. Japan coming out on top of that one, 16-12, despite the blocks coming back on them. Also helped out considerably by three ace serves. So, two sets down, we're level. Which way is this one going to go? Can Canada, who we know are fighters, get themselves back in front again, or can Japan just start going through the gears here? Start of this third set, then no changes for either side. They've gone back to where they started the first two sets. Lovely second touch there from Byron Keturakis. We've seen quite a few of those from him. Always want to just catch the opposition, not expecting it. If they know it's coming, you can look really bad. They didn't see that one coming. Take side for Shimizu. Oh, Hoag's done brilliantly well. Can he get a winner out of it? Oh, the block has contained him. Hoag will have another go and he'll swing through this. He'll come back. Hoag with the push this time. That doesn't work either. Now Japan can transition. Shimizu denied. Yanagida got it. And Akihiro can't find a winner either. Keturakis took that. Hoag again. Took a touch. The call took a touch. Well, Yuichi Nakagaichi is looking at his players. I did it touch him, and obviously, he's got the message. Yep, it did. That's another ace. Keturakis. Zip that one into the bottom corner there. And look at this. For the third set in a row, one team starts off red hot.
Yeah, that comes out stone cold. It's Canada front running here. Wonder how much longer Japan will stand for this. Not the best it takes from Koga either. They're really struggling to get anything going here in this third set early. Shimizu, oh, I'm not sure he's got anything there. He hasn't, no. Canada absolutely running away with this third set. How close must he be to saying time out here? Ryuichi Nakagaishi, though, resisting the temptation. Ketsurakis. Koga made a mess of that. They've managed to keep it alive. That should have been a put away. Will they pay for it? Not necessarily. That's kept alive. Hogue will swing. Kept alive by Fuji. Shimizu finally does get Japan on the board. And they've tossed away 4 points in a row there. Missed opportunity there to make it 5 in a row for Japan as well. Well, they do like to make it hard for themselves, don't they? Maybe that adds to the fun. Yamauchi would serve, not the best of takes. Yeah, Japan might just get a bite at this. Izuhara, did it take a touch? Yes. I'm sure Canada are hugely impressed at that. Or are they? Is it one of those where you just say, yeah, all right, it was on me. Even though you don't want it. You don't want to believe it. But it is. Japan trying to get their way back into this one. Vernon doesn't find a winner there. Lee cut it off. Izuhara denied by the cross court from Ma. Vernon again. No, nothing there for him. Half attack. Empty there for Yamagina. Yeah, that's nice. He enjoyed that. So did this crowd. More to the point. Japan, will they get away with it? Ketsurakis tries to settle it back down, and Ma denied brilliantly. Izuhara with a tough take, and it's a beauty, though. Oh, that's the best swing he's had in this match. That's a big one. Well, Tsubasa Izuhara was asked to do an awful lot of work here. Brilliant rescue from Koga. Ma thought he's got a winner. Koga stretching out there. The put away, absolutely beautiful. Now then, momentum switches again, big time. Canada's lead gone. They won't be very happy about this. Even less happy when they see that Shimizu's back there, because Shimizu's serves been getting better and better. Good one. Hogue's only just got a piece of that. Now, where's this going to end up? It's going to end up with Izuhara, who's come up with another one. And a
tell you, was leading the cheers there. Yuichi Nakagaichi. He introduced Isahara into his squad midway through the competition. He's thrown him in here. And he's had his problems early, but he's suddenly caught fire. Derek Epp will come back in for Byron Keturakis.
And Japan look to continue to pour it on. 7 points out of eight here. Just missing. They needed that, Canada, that's for sure. They need a whole lot more. They've got no energy at all. That was great from Daniela Guida. Easy put away. Always nice to get a freebie, isn't it? That's not going to get spurred by Stephen Mark. Everybody loves a freebie. Isahara looks for another one, doesn't get it. Ma measures that one up. Shimizu gets underneath it. Shimizu will get third touch as well. The block's contained it again. Sent on its way by Jansen van Doorn. Isahara finds another one. This is a real bonus for Japan. Tsubasa Isahara has found his range and really got into this match. That'll take Japan after that dreadful start into the first technical timeout in front. Up in this match now. Here we are, early stages in the third set, and basically we can't separate them. Make sure we cannot separate them at all. We're dead level. Of that. Finishes the job. Marshall was there guarding the down the line, and oh, just absolutely ripped through that one.
again.
Watch this swing here from Nick Hogue. Oh. Absolutely electrifying this. From Fuji, and they keep this alive here, Japan. Yamagida gets blocked out of it. Beautiful. Daniel Jansen Van Dorn didn't want to see that point turn around. He was there. He had company. And it's another block for DJV. Send that back with interest. Be a real nuisance at the net, isn't he? Nobu picks that one up nicely. Should be the put away. Good enough. That'll send the dangerous Yamagida back there. Canada's lead here in this third set. Well, they came from a long way back right at the start. They're going to have to chase again. That one misses for them this time. Side out. Reception. Oh, a miscue there from Yamagida again. He's really finding his range here now. Tsubasa Isahara with another one. Couldn't find a winner from anywhere through the first two sets, it seemed. Finding him all over the place in this third set. Still chasing. Need a point on serve. Got it. Right there. Kunihiro Shimizu finds an ace. Drops it onto the sideline. They've come back again. Really good stuff, this. Crowd's got into it. Shimizu. Where will he go this time? A similar one, Hogue got it. It was not a winner, they thought it was. Danny Demyanenko thought he'd got it first time. Pipe attack from Hogue is successful. Second time around, Japan continue to chase then here. Canada front running. It's Danny Demyanenko brought in off the bench for Van Berkel. Plenty of power. better take from Yanagida this time. And he's found another winner. That's a little bit fortuitous there for Isahara. Mighty close to a stuff block. But you don't care how it comes, as long as the points do come. At the moment, we are level, 15 all. Isahara will serve. It's not a good take, that, from Ma, but he's got time to measure here, and then gets blocked, but just like the previous one, that block doesn't stay in play. So, we're at the technical timeout. This third set is there for the taking.
Remember, go across for tip. Make sure we're going across on both sides. Okay, they're tipping right here. F, okay.
Hey, on three man though, just come behind. They're not burning anything online.
We give them the blocked out line. Okay, we don't give them this and this. Make sure we go across on two men. In transition, you can still go middle and then go for tip.
One, two men.
Situation when it's sweaty palm time near the end of a set. Ma takes that one, hangs it up there, we'll get a third touch as well. Lee picks that one up. Zanagida, excuse me, and Shimizu finds a way through somehow. Daniel Jansen Van Thorn got hands on this. So too did Stephen Ma. Both of them lost the ball. So now they are front running. Now it's Canada's turn to chase. Let's see if Lee can find something here. Good at finding gaps, Haku Lee. Let's see if he can find the gap here. No, he can't. Hogue's read that. That's clever. Good at finding gaps. DJV. Now to stay level. Oh, stomps back to his position. Serve here. Here he goes. Nice take from Yanagida. Oh, dear, dear. Could have done a little bit better with that one. Isahara did send it straight at him. And it wasn't that powerful a hit. And Vernon will look at this and say, oh, right, well, that's what's happened. No, no, take that back. A little deflection there off Jansen Van Doorn completely changed the flight of that. And I don't think Vernon was expecting it. Tough take that. So, Fuji. Still lets a run! Now they lead. And a serve from Nanobu Fuji. Now it's Nick Hogue's turn and think, I wish I'd done better with that one. It dipped on him. Once that happened, he was in trouble. Canada are now chasing. They have to call timeout and do.
That's okay. We got
to
dip. We have our, like.
No, just ball it and then you ran the C ball. I really. but
they're running middle pipe and everything is back to one. So on the pipe, 6 and 1, we got to pick up just one or two balls. Okay, middles will be there with a hand for deviation, so be patient. We need to collapse behind the block every time, no matter what. That's what they got right now. When you're digging in one, turn, because he's external. It's going to keep going. Okay, we play that inside.
Down the line, you can't see the ball anymore from the block. Go forward. We'll cover you on the long. What do you?
Hey, why do you
want to
do this for sure? We don't forget that I want you to drop them off already once. Huh?
But what do you want to do, yeah?
Well, we reach a very important point in this third set, then, don't we? Japan now have a lead to protect. Can they build on that lead here? Off the ace serve from now Nobu Fuji, or will Canada side out to stay close? Hogue does a much better job with this one. He should finish the job. Just took a really tight angle there, Hogue. Take an angle like this, you're not getting a block, it's not coming back. But there is a risk that you'll send it too far. Hogue got that one absolutely perfect. Side out, necessary side out. Jansen van Doorn looking to level it up here for Canada. Easy take for Hisahara. Good score, good for Yanagida. Japan side out. Canada will have to serve a little bit better than that if they want to bring the point back on serve. They've also got to have their service reception game intact here, because it's Masahiro Yanagida who does bring it. Looking to increase Japan's edge here, and it is an edge, that's all it is, it's tight. Beautiful take. Oh, they've got it under control now, Canada. They'll send it over to Hogue. Hogue runs it off the block. Well, it was a sizzler of a serve. Somehow they kept it up. And when they were able to transit, they had an ace earlier. Almost got another one there. Lovely push. Really nice job there. Oh, Shimizu. Yamauchi there into the net. So that Canada still just needs this 1 point to bring this back to full square. I think Hogue is due up next. This serves always challenge. Another one that's challenged as well, but a really nice take, and brilliant puts it away. Big assist to Masahiro Yanagida for that. Perfect service reception here. Hung it up for the center. Fuji's delivery was terrific. Haku Lee driving through, sent that back from whence it came. Side out. Japan 22-20. This has become a grinding side out duel. Whose nerve is going to crack here? Hisahara sends one too long. That keeps Canada right in touch. And you need that 1 point, remember. Demyanenko sends in a beauty. Yanagida's done a brilliant job again. And will they get this under control? Yes, they will. Ma with a tough take. Shimizu rips it down the line. Oh, this was terrific. Lovely backside set. Shimizu's faced a block, but manages to just slip it inside Stephen Ma. And away. Ma had a chance at it, but it was a tough take. Triple substitution for Japan. What about this? Nishida, Ishikawa, Sekita, all coming in. That's a big switch up. Canada, of course, immediately have to respond. with a timeout.
Look, for second opportunity, we're committing on the middle. So you got to, especially if one's front row, guys, we got to commit. Just release. It's too fast. Just go to your guys now and then come back for anything we can get.
Wholesale changes on court for Japan then. A triple substitution. Tsubasa Hisahara serving at 23-21. Ma takes. What a beautiful cross-court put away from Murdoch. Still Canada tucked in. But they're running out of time to get this point back. If this one is a side out, Japan are at set point. What can Burnham find here? It's into the net. It's Haku Lee going back to serve. Lots of big blockers up there for Japan. This is going to be a 2-1 Japan lead. Lee sends this one over. Nice take from Ho. Got to be good from Ma. Kept up brilliantly. Can they push something here? Ishikawa denied. Where is that going to go? Yeah, now they might be able to transition out here with Ishikawa. Vernon's kept it alive. Somehow Marshall sends it backside. That's a tricky one. Somehow it stayed alive from Ma. Marshall brilliant again. Ho over to Ma. And there's a whistle. And there was an encroachment into the net there. So that's Canada's point. That's a big, big anticlimax. Both teams had chances. Both teams played some outstanding defense there as well. And that's typical Canada. They fight you for everything. That was some rally. With the anticlimax ending. Canada don't care about that. They've got to find a point right here. On the Stephen Marr serve. They've been chasing and chasing and chasing after that early lead. They've hung close. Can they level it up? No, they can't. Marr with the netter. Japan take the third set. That was a grinding battle that went right down to the wire. But Japan ended up on the right side of the line. And they take this important third set. If Canada want to take this match, they'll have to take it into a fifth set, and that's something they are more than capable of. But right now, Japan, where they want to be, in front after that slow start. They dropped the first set, fell behind early in the third set, 5-0 down, but came back to win it. is the numbers then from that third set. Again, Japan winning the attack battle. The blocks haven't hurt them too much, just the one came back at them. Ace serves level. That's a close one. That could have gone either way. Those are the sets you have to win. You want to win matches. Shimizu stepping up big time, and Hisahara really emerging as a weapon in that third set as well. Shimizu has emerged as the top scorer in this match so far, moving ahead of Stephen Marr. Hisahara, Vernon and Hogue all tucked in just behind two front runners. Now, is this going to be the last set of the 2019 World Cup? Well, that's how Japan had won it. But Canada are the masters of the five-set marathon. And they drag it into a tiebreaker. Fourth set underway then. Canada trailing 2-1, needing this one. Take from Hisahara. Side out. Solid start. Fourth set. That was sent. Rangy Akihiro Yamauchi back there. Can Japan get a point or two on serve early to really put Canada under pressure here? Easy take for Ma, should be put away for Hogue, and it is. Straightforward by the numbers stuff. All the skipper had to do was find that big gap right on the 3 meter line there. Job done. Side out. Hogue will now serve, and it's a terrible time. Here is Yanagida, who's had one or two little wobbles. Sends one off at a strange angle. Never good when you see it going off like that. So Hogue will say, I'll take the ace. Count of the front running. Serving 2-2. Staying right where he is, a lovely second touch, but it doesn't work. It's only a lovely second touch when it works. Third touch from Stephen Marr didn't work either. That's a missed opportunity again. How close was that though? Here's Vernon. four. It's full set, rattling along at a fair old pace.
Beaver!
Ma with take. Ma with third touch. It's another one of those serves that just didn't really do much of anything. They have to be just dealt with. With a bit of a fuss. Test of takes from Miller Gieder. He gets blocked there as well. The backside. There's a call there. Shimizu. He'll pick up the win. Fuji, who managed to produce an ace. I shall grab it out of a hat in the last set. Serves Hoag this time. Hoag will get third touch as well. There's a lot of contact on the net. Hoag has just run into it. Oh dear. Could bring his momentum under control. So Fuji will stay back there. This man down for a couple of aces at the start of this match, you'd have got some funny looks. Yeah, Hoag will check out as Riley Barnes will come in. That's smart. When a guy's having a wobble, let him just rest up. So here's Fuji again. Mixing it up nicely. Marshall with the take this time. Barnes has missed it in his first swing. It's a miss. That will take Japan into the first technical timeout with a lead and with some momentum. Chasing a couple of points again. We'll see the back of Naonobu Fuji here. An unexpected turn of events to see the Fuji serve causing such problems. That shouldn't cause any problems at all, but the block's in there. Oh my goodness, everything's coming on for them. I'm not sure if that was Yamauchi or Yanagida. They were there together. That was a little large show. They combined to send Sharon Vernon on his bike. Now this is starting to open up nicely. Another serve from Fuji.
Again, not a tough one. Barnes takes that pretty comfortably. The push finally. Chief side out for Canada. Maher making that one easy. It'll be DJV up to serve next. Canada chasing 3 points here. Comfortable take. Cross court. Shimizu who's just reached the 20-point threshold here. Big gap to exploit. Defenses stretched all along the net there. Now Yanagida. He's a very, very big server indeed. Nice take from Marshall, really perfectly handled. And Barnes just has to think that all on, but Fujii's read it. Here comes Shimizu again, and he's pushed that off the block. It's another point for Japan. Wonderful stuff, this. Now we're going to see a switch up for Canada. Hoge will come back in for Barnes. I wonder if they'll go straight after him here on serve. Yanagida. Hard to miss Ming Ho, very distinctive presence on the other side of the net. Does Yanagida go after him? No, he doesn't. He sent it the other way and it's missed. Big one. Now Canada needed that. Got some serious chasing to do here. Slow start. A lot of coaches would have said, no, I'm going to bring the 18 back on. And he's resisted that. And he's getting his reward now. And no winner there for Yamauchi. Hoge will look for the push. And he's dropped it onto the line beautifully. That's a point back. That's Canada making this deficit manageable. Read that really well, didn't he? We kept dropping back to serve. Tuning Philippe Blaine has managed to come up with there as Epps stays on serve. Got a take from Yanagida. And it's just gone out. Treading a very fine line there. He's getting challenged, it is. Well, it was a close one. Technology though. So serve. Taken by Hoge. Should be a put away here for Werner. He's absolutely right. Get a bit more solid against Canada. Have they come out of that slump? And an easy serve to take. Got what it deserved. So Werner Dunn does his bit. Hoge drops back to serve. 12-10. Young Peter's got the back in first touch. Marble smashed out away. And suddenly Canada storming through again. Just as they do. No quitting the Canadians. Really got to treat them like vampires. Just drive the stake in the heart. It's the only thing that will stop them. Hoge looking to level it up. Tough take this. Oh. It looked a tough take. He made that look really easy. Zahara faced with the block and a defender down the line has managed to beat all of them and drop it in. Super stuff that. Shimizu. Hope with the take. Deciding out really well now. Canada. Japan serve just doesn't seem to be bothering them. It's big serving. Danny Dean is going to be coming up next. After that put away. This is a player you always think has got an ace lurking somewhere. Really important take from Yanagida. He's a hard denied this time, but he will get second touch. Hosted over for Shimizu, who was really clever. Really clever there. That was a three-man block set, ready to smash it back. Shimizu adjusted. Went for the dink instead. Look at that. If he tried to swing through that, that block would have sent it back. Beautiful from the veteran. If you've been around as long as he has, you know one or two tricks. You pick a few things up. Every chance it's going to happen, you will not get good odds. That's a good one. Yanagida driving through far side.
Don't be late.
can Japan push on and wrap this up? And Canada extended into a tiebreaker. It's an interesting moment for now Nobu Fuji to turn up and serve. Hogue's not exactly handled that brilliantly, but Derrick has. Beautiful second touch. That's what you want your center to do. Made the most of a mess. Wasn't a great take at all. Yeah, pounced on that. Jansen van Doorn then looking to break this tie. They're still chasing here, Japan. Another point on serve though, we'll have them front running. Almost slipped away. That's got to be good. All sorts of stuff going on the net there. And the point goes to Canada. Yanagida ripped through the net there. No. Can't hit the net. The antenna rattle around. That's the break they needed, Canada. And they get the block point in there as well. Now we are on course for that tiebreaker. And it's Japan who have to call a timeout.
Hey, manage your block, huh? It seems that they don't go to strong serve now. Many blocks and everything. Ready for taking this one. Allez, you have to take a side on this one. Allez, come on. Yo!
Probably their best server on court right now. Do something about that. Well, Marshall sent that backwards. Hogue's got to watch this very closely. Tough take, tough take. You see those missed a lot. Canada now have to take a timeout. Their lead gone.
You gotta watch the net, and Danny's here. Okay, we can high ball this scenario, guys. Take your wrist to the net. If not, you know, someone's gotta yell, no blockers. We can push the pot. Okay, push the pot.
Well, it's the right man at the service line for Japan. Not been any doubt about that. So the immediate problem has been solved. We're back on side out. Now, Japan get at least get ahead here at 18-all in this fourth set. Absolutely no margin for error now. Here comes Yanagida. It's a sizzler. Mar's done really well with that. Hogue has got another tough take and has made a really nice job of that. They're missable too. Hogue has sent it down the line beautifully. So Canada still front running here. Yeah. We'll look for something here. Give Canada.
the control of the set deep into this fourth set. Got to be side out for Japan to stay on terms. Goes soft. Yanagida picks that up. Shimizu's blocked out and finally comes. Once again, very control. Not a great service reception again. Tougher than it looked, take this for Shimizu. Codes wiped him out. Maybe that's the moment that confirms that we are going into a fifth set here. It'll be Canada's sixth five-setter. And they've kept this alive as well. Marshall just sends that over. Got to deal with this Japan. Pipe attack. Rips it inside out. Well, the crowd celebrates, but those are the kind of points you have to win. They're the gimmies. He did what he needed to do. Still chasing here, and their serving is not causing Canada any problems at all. You might she find something. Oh, it's an overpass from Ma. That's a mistake. Ma's got back though. And Vernon will try and put this away. He can't. Yanagida. Shimizu goes for the dink. Brilliant from Ma. He's flying around. Vernon overhits it badly. They're going to challenge it. I think this has got to take, this has taken a touch. It was a very confident challenge. Well, it all started on Ma's overpass. But Ma was the man that helped keep that point alive. And is there anything there? No, there is not. Once again, Japan. Get out the way of a bullet. They fight off another deficit. But surely they can't benefit from another overpass on serve again. Yamauchi. A 20-all here in this fourth set. Welch is falling over to pick that one up. Oh, misses. Oh, no, he's got it. Now the flag went up. So the line judge said that's out. In the chair, they said it's good. So this one's got to be challenged, obviously, especially this close. The call at the moment in the chair is a Canada point that it's in. Let's see. Now, well, this is that. The call is excellent in the chair. Stay in front. Now Japan have to side out. They can't be trying to chase a deficit again this deep in the competition. Fuji hangs up there. Shimizu. Absolute beauty across court with an awful lot of traffic to navigate here as well. He's made this look easy. Shimizu had an awful lot to beat and had to drop it inside the sideline. Wonderful stuff. So we're level still. Shimizu will now serve. Both teams, 4 points from the finish. But remember, you have to win by two clear points. Yanenko doesn't find a winner there, but they will reset here. Oh, driving in. Oh, that's brilliant from Koga. Isahara! Wonderful, wonderful defensive work. Isahara with a confident swing, but all of the players are going over to Taichiro Koga for that dig right there. That set this up. Yes, he's got to smash the block. He did. But he wouldn't have had a play at all if Koga hadn't kept that up. Now, Japan front running again. This is must side out time for Canada. Shimizu drops it in. Demyanenko doesn't do a great job with that. Ma with the take. That's clever, that's clever. Huge, huge separation between the front row and the back row there. All Ma had to do was drop it in the middle, which he did. still level. Demianenko trying to get Canada back in front. Not a great take. Isahara gets blocked. Kept alive somehow. No play there, though. It's all on service reception again. They keep putting themselves in bad spots here, Canada. Yanagin has just had a tough, tough time on service reception. There we go, the triple substitution. Nishida, Ishikawa, Sekita all coming in. Been very warmly received, and it's Yanagida, one of the three that's going. Chidi's gone as well. And Shimizu. Well, looking to try and go for the finish here. First, they've got to get side out here, Japan. Danny Demianenko with a serve that could take Canada to set point. Tough take. This might be coming back. Ma, it is. It's a beauty. Canada go to set point. Take for Ma. Ma will look for the put away and gets it. What else did you expect? This is Canada. Five setters is what they do. They're going to do another one.
Thank you.
the numbers then from that fourth set. Canada winning the attack battle 16-13, and the blocks rain down on Japan there. That's always been their Achilles heel. Whenever they're blocked like that, they struggle to win sets. Well, you're going to struggle to win a set if you've been out blocked 5-1. That's exactly what happened there. Canada, yet again, take a match into a tiebreaker. They have mixed fortunes, coming up on the wrong side of it against the USA and Russia, but ending up on the right side against Egypt, Tunisia, and most recently, Italy. Their sixth out of 11 World Cup matches going all the way. Typical Canada. They fight you for every point. They've given themselves a chance. They're finishing on a high. The last match for the 2019 FIBA World FIBB World Cup is going to be decided over 5 sets. And it's a sprint to 15. No margin for error. Well, Yanagida's had his problems with service reception, but his serving has been of a consistently high standard. Can he get Japan off to a flyer? Hoge with a wonderful pickup. Hoge with third touch. This has got to be accurate. Tsubasa finds one off the block. Tsubasa Isahara just got better and better. Now still now emerging as one of the steadiest presences for Japan. This is 15th point. Only Shimizu for Japan has more. So that'll keep Yanagida there. That's a bonus. That's a beauty. Mara struggled with that one. Vernon with a tough take, just has to punch it over. They can set here. Yanagida on the back attack drives in. Japan off to a flyer. Yanagida's serving is proving crucial here. So they're front running. As we saw in that last set, you don't count Canada out until the last point is scored. Japan had a big lead in that fourth set and couldn't hold on to it. Yanagida will want to just keep pouring it on and pouring it on. That's too long. Hoge rips one in. What a stretch there for Shimizu. He's managed to just scrub it off the block there. That was a tough take. Lovely pick up again from Koga. Such an entertaining libero, isn't he? Backside set. Got some work to do. Pushes it off. Steven Marsh, Shimizu. Didn't put anything on it at all. So there was no momentum. But had to come back over the net. Yamauchi. Ma with an easy pickup. Ma with the swing. That's blocked. But they should be able to pick it up at the second time. Demianenko's blocked. They're in trouble. They lose the point. Well, Haku Lee did some really good defensive work there for Japan. He was in the middle of that. Demianenko just couldn't get through, could he? Got to be side out here for Canada. This is a sprint to 15, not 25. They cannot allow this gap to grow any wider. It's a much better take from Mark. Finishes the job as well. Says no, we're not, we're chasing one. This is Canada, they can handle that. Demianenko drills one right inside the sideline. But he went aggressive.
aggressive, and you have to stay aggressive. There's been one problem that Japan have had over the course of this match. Their serving just hasn't challenged on a consistent basis. Canada have been able to side out very effectively. Shimizu. That's a decent one. Marshall's got a very nice take on that. Blocked! I think that might have been Fuji. Well, it's a little setter. Has come up with a couple of aces. Now, he's conjured up a block. That's huge bonus points. He's loving it. Some guys thrive on pressure. Fuji, obviously one of them. Shimizu looking to put some pressure on here. Grabbed off the floor there. And brilliantly recovered by Stephen Ma. That's a huge play. Ma's kept Canada alive here. I think even they could have come back from dropping another point. We'll take Ma up to 25 points along with Shimizu. Vernon goes long side out. It's looking like the three amigos are coming back in. Ishikawa, Nishida, Sekita. Japan looking to wrap this up here. Tsubasa Hisahara, who will serve here at 7-4. It's a beauty, sneak down the line. Vernon only just caught that. Ma will have to go for it and does brilliantly. They left too big a gap, and Ma has been finding those holes very consistently all night long. Side out. There's another one. Extra height and is a better blocker. Now Japan still have a lead here, but suddenly Canada are challenging. What can they do off that big error? There's another error there. Koga mishandles. Got to be good from Ishikawa. He's missed. Oh my goodness me. Japan tossing this away here. Wow, back-to-back errors. And that's all they are. They weren't forced.
Hey guys, he's still blocked, huh? Ah, right, good reception. Take care. Ah. Take care, number four. Ah. You have a good block.
Yeah, that's it.
Good line. Ah, okay. All right.
Look for them to lose the middle. Okay, they're gonna go away from Shoal. Sorry, firing. Look, on 11. 11 is two angles. You're alone. You split.
Handled service reception. They're in trouble here. They really are in trouble. They're unraveling Japan. Final set into chasing it. floats one over. And there's Sakita go backside. Now a lot of angle. But managed to thread it in. Big point. Haku Lee. With a nice take, Ho with an absolute cross-court kill. No margin for error with that one. No words coming back. Backside set, Nishida too good, runs it off the block. Both red, couldn't stop it. There's blockers in here for Japan as they look to get in front. Shimizu's in there on the front row to try and get a block. Ooh, it's a beauty. Nishida with an ace. Well, his arm's fresh and he always brings it. Can they turn it around again here, Japan? They're front running again. Canada are looking to make a change here, I think. Maybe they're not going to bring it. We're talking about looking to bring it in Jason DeRocco, I think. Well, it's not happened, and he's lost that one, Ho. That's back-to-back aces. Nishida on his own and has just turned this fifth set Japan's way. DeRocco is coming in now. Vernon is going out. Not able to make that. Bench management issues going on here. Sada has just had to take center stage, get everything set where he wants it, the scoring table. He's now happy. Everyone's happy. What has that delay done to Nishida? Well, Miles, or other hopes got under it. He gets blocked back!
Surely this is too much heat for Canada to come back from. It's another absolute beauty of a serve. They fake the swing. And it's Akihiro Yamauchi with the stuff to send Canada surely packing. They can't come back from this. Changes now. Ma checks out, Barnes in, but the damage has been done, and surely there's no coming back from this. Japan, 2 points from wrapping this one up. It's another beauty of tonight's again. Unbelievable from Yuji Nishida. Went straight after Barnes, who rather stepped in front of home. They couldn't cope with it at all, could they? We are at match point. 4 aces out of 5 serves have absolutely destroyed Canada. They call a timeout. They might as well wave a white flag.
No, timeout first. That's my bad. I took that one. But we never fucking give up. There's always hope. Let's go.
1, 2, 3.
Everybody's on their feet at the Green Arena in Hiroshima. They've been dragged up and down on a roller coaster by their team in this very last match of the 2019 World Cup that has gone to the very last set. And it's taken Yuji Nishida and some devastating serving to finally put Canada on the brink. Can he wrap it up? Can he wrap up the competition with yet another ace? Here he goes. He has. Unbelievable. Incredible. What a finish for Japan. What a way to end the 2019 FIVB World Cup. Some good, some not so good. What we all knew, Yuji Nishida is a serious offensive weapon. Out of the bullpen, onto the service line, and it's game over. Nick Hogan, a really good performance today. He's had a great World Cup as well. He couldn't deal with those serves. Nor could Stephen Maher, who's made a huge contribution as well. They just couldn't handle it when it really mattered. That is some way to end the competition, isn't it? Japan won't be on the podium, but if there's a better scorer in the competition than Yuji Nishida, we'd all like to see who it is. It's a team game, but one man has made the difference in this one. 19 years old. He's only going to get better. How good will he be when the Olympics in Tokyo roll around in about 8 months, 9 months' time? This one's over. There's the story. 5 aces. That's all you need to know. take a look at the overall numbers then. Really close with the tack points. Canada winning the black, the blocking battle, of course, 10-5. And then the serve duel was close until Yuji Nishida decided to come in and take personal responsibility for getting Japan over the line. Japan win this one in three sets to two. And in many ways, the best serving of the whole competition was saved for the very end. Absolutely wonderful, wonderful finish. Superb finale for a competition that has been a pleasure to be involved with right from the start. Japan has hosted first the Women's World Cup last month. Now the men. Well, they've done so absolutely wonderfully. They've been so warm, welcoming, accommodating, organized. Everything has been perfect. I guess the only thing that Japan could have asked for was a medal. But fourth place in the World Cup is a significant achievement. There will be a presentation ceremony of the medals coming up once they've managed to clear all the players away, get the net down and build the podium. So there will be a short delay, so stick around with us to see the medals awarded to the United States, to Poland, and of course to the gold medalist Brazil. Best of the rest, Japan, no question.
So I'm with Taichiro Koga from Team Japan. First of all, a great win to wrap up the tournament. That's victory number 8, I think, for Japan. How did you feel about the overall tournament?
In general, we played quite good, high levels, and you know, getting confidence, so you know, it's really good for, you know, Tokyo Olympics.
Yes, and talking about the Olympics, do you think this tournament was a good tournament to get ready for next year?
Yeah, it's really good, get confidence, so yeah, it's really good for us.
You know, this is going to be a really hard question, but can we expect a medal from Team Japan in the Olympics next year?
Yes, of course, yes. You know, we have to make step by step, so, you know. But we believe that we will take a medal, yeah.
But with the current Japan team, it's really strong. All the other teams are saying that Japan is really strong. So I think you have a great momentum going. I think it's a great team, so I wish you the best of luck. Could you give a final message to all the fans, volleyball fans?
Yeah, first of all, it's thanks for cheering for us to end of point. We showed this competition it's quite high level, so we keep really hard, and we will see how it's going on, but we believe that we will take a medal in Olympics.
I wish you the best of luck. Once again, congratulations.
Taichiro Koga aiming high. An Olympic medal might be a little bit beyond Japan, but you've got to go for it. And on the improvement that we've seen over the last few months, they might have an outside chance, especially with home advantage. They get a well-deserved victory photograph. It's been quite a competition for Japan. And that team is a team that's going places.
way to bring the curtain down on the men's FIVB World Cup 2019. Japan finished with 8 victories, and they served up literally the best right at the end. It's gold for Brazil, silver for Poland. The United States take the bronze. And that is a competition that will live long in the memory. We've really enjoyed it. We will have the medal ceremony in just a few moments. Stick around for that and join us again in just a few minutes' time.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we ask you to remain in your seats to attend the awarding and closing ceremony for the FIVB Volleyball Men's World Cup 2019.
まもなく FIVB ワールドカップバレーボール2019男子大会表彰式並びにクロージングセレモニーを行います。どうぞ皆様、お席の方でお待ちください。
ただいまより FIVB ワールドカップバレーボール2019男子大会表彰式を行います。
So it's a bronze medal then for the USA, who started off this competition with the big surprise of this FIVB World Cup when they were beaten in five sets by Argentina. Recovered well, couldn't beat Brazil, did beat Poland. Would have been knocked back into the bronze medal. It's just the two defeats then for the Poles. Reigning world champions will have to settle for World Cup silver after losing to the United States and, of course, to the gold medalists who are about to be introduced.
And the champions, Brazil!
And what champions? Brazil, World Cup winners for the third time in their history. Making it three Olympic Games golds, three World Championships, now three World Cups, and how they won it in style. Won every match, won 10 out of the 11. Inside four, won most of them in straight sets. Only Poland threatened them, no question. And the best team in the tournament are Brazil.
National teams.
これよりチームの表彰式を行います。 FIVB ワールドカップバレーボール男子大会第3位銅メダル、
FIVB Volleyball Men's World Cup 2019 The third place and bronze medal winners are USA!
So the United States take bronze of the 2019 FIVB Men's World Cup. The presentation of the medals will be made by Mr. Majore Louis Timba, technical delegate of FIVB Volleyball Men's World Cup 2019, and by Mr. Mushtaq Mohamed, CC president of FIVB Volleyball Men's World Cup 2019, both of whom are FIVB Board of Administration members.
そして国際バレーボール連盟エクエイビーバレーボールワールドカップ2019男子大会テクニカルデレゲートアトライルイスティンバによりブロンズプレートの銅メダル、そして賞金が授与されます。
Competition. Oh, they brought a smile to everyone's faces every time they've been on court. Right, they've saved up a little treat right for the last. They came in literally 48 hours after taking bronze in the European Championship. World champions a year ago. World Cup silver medalists in 2019, and to present the medals. Mr. Yuji Sayeki, president of Mikasa Corporation, and Mr. Kenji Shimaoka, president of Japan Volleyball Association.
Captain number 13, Mihao Kumia. Number 17, Babel Natolsky. Number 2, Maciej Buzan. Number 4, Malchin Komenda. Number 5, Ukash Kaczmalek. Number 7, Altul Shalotok. Number 9, Wilfred Leon. Number 11, Maria Jitska. FIVB ワールドカップバレーボール男子大会第1位金メダル FIVB Volleyball Men's World Cup 2019 The champions and gold medal winners are Brazil!
Absolutely wonderful, wonderful performance once again from Brazil. They were top of the podium at Rio. Here they are, top of the podium once again at the FIVB Men's World Cup. To present the medals, Mr. Shin Tomoka, the Senior Executive Director, Sports Department of Fuji Television Network, and Mr. Cristobal Marta Hoffies, FIVB First Executive Vice President.
Captain number 1, Bruno. Number 17, Dennis. Number 2, Izaki. And number 5, Mauricio. Fernando.
Mikey. And number 16, Lucas. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the playing of the national anthem of Brazil.
それでは優勝チームブラジルの国歌演奏です。会場の皆様はどうぞご起立、ご脱帽の上、会場北側の国旗にご注目ください。
So there we are then, confirmation that it's bronze for the United States, silver for Poland, and gold for Brazil. That officially brings the FIVB Volleyball Men's World Cup 2019 to a conclusion. It's been a wonderful competition. We've enjoyed every moment of it. Hope you have too as well.
The first best outside spiker is
Wilfred Leon, number 9 from Poland! Congratulations, Maxwell Holt! And the second best middle blocker is Lucas, number 16 from Brazil!
President of Japan, Honorable Association. Best of Awotin Tosono Presentama.
And finally, the most valuable player is Allen, number 21, Brad Marshall!
MVP score for us. MVP score. That's you. Number 21. Allen Sessions.
FIVB Volleyball Men's World Cup 2019. The champions and gold medal winners are Brazil!
世界消防男子特訓優秀チームによって明日出される会場世界最高峰のバレーボールを担当させてくれた FMVBワールドカップバレーボールの2019男子団体初代戦は中部男子大会は裏手裏見事優勝を飾り世界王者の称号を手にしました9月14日以来の始まりです10月15日までの全132試合会場で戦い全員を世界の選手たちに送ってくれた バレーボールファンの皆様本当にありがとうございます。